Hello everyone, welcome back to Swayam Siksha. Well, today I wanted to discuss the UIP and the Stands for Me Death. So due to Stands for Me Death, this UAPA was actually came into the focus, so which is an Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. Now, before heading into the UAPA and what the Stands for Me Death leads to and all, we need to discuss some historical event. So where here, as you could see, now we are going to discuss about Bhima Koregaon battle. So this battle was actually fought, in 1818. So where, the army, so a battle was fought between, the Peshwa forces and the British government. So the British army was which comprised mainly of Dalit soldiers who are from Maha community. Okay, so where they fought the upper caste dominated Peshwa army. So the British troops actually defeated the Peshwa army. Like, why? Because the Peshwa Bajirao II has actually insulted, the Maha community and terminated them from the service of his army. So this caused them to, take the side with English and fought against, the Peshwa's army. So because the defeat of this Peshwa army, which was actually considered as a victory, okay, so this was actually considered as a victory against caste-based discrimination and oppression. So on that note, where as you could see the valor, where you could see it over here, and not only that, it was one of the last battles of Third Anglo-Maratha War. Okay, so this was the last where the Anglo-Maratha War has actually taken and which ended the Peshwa's domination in Maratha region. And not only that, as you could see the picture over here, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who actually visited the site on Jan 1st, 1927, so where, revitalized the memory of the battle for the Dalit community and making it as a rally point and an accession of pride. Okay, so yes, since then it's become a very famous celebration for Dalit people or the Maha community in Maharashtra. So as you could see over here, the victory pillar, which was called as Runs Thumb. Okay. Runs Thumb. So this was called as Runs Thumb. This was in Bhima Koregaon village, which is in Pune district of Maharashtra. So yes, every year on Jan 1st, where the celebration is going to happen near this village. So yes, why are we talking about this celebrations? Because on this celebrations, where on 2018, where it was making it an 200th anniversary, from this battle. So, there has been a kind of a communities or, several collision. Okay, so why are we talking about this celebrations and all? Because on 2018, there has been the 200th anniversary of this Battle of Bhima Koregaon. So where a coalition of several organizations where, they conducts on Elagar Parishad in Shaniwarwada in Pune. So on that time, what actually happened means on the 200th celebration, there has been violence. So where the violence has been breakout on the celebrations and, it leads to a person died and several injuries were actually happened on the clashes. So on that violence case, so where the Stand Swami, who is nothing but like he is a tribal rights activist and a Jewish priest. So he was actually arrested on that violence case. Okay, so that's why he was came into the picture. And not only him, there are so many several activists who have been, arrested, and they've just proved that there has been an alleged, connection between this violence where, so that's why he has been booked under India's stringent anti-terror law, which is the Unlawful Activities Prevention Law, which is UAPA. So that is why we are discussing about UAPA today and why it needs to be repealed. So that was came into the focus, recently into the news because of his death. So yes, he was died when he was taken up for the custody and, he was literally suffering from so many health conditions and due to even he got affected with corona and then he was died in the hospital itself while he was taking, the proper medical attention, and due to cardiac arrest, he was actually expired. So that's why this was all came into the news, like who is this Dan Swamy and why he was arrested, on what, you know, he was arrested. So he was arrested on or under UAPA Act. So what is this UAPA Act was? It's an anti-terrorist law. So why he was taken up into the anti-terrorist law, on what basis? Because of the 2018, where this 200th anniversary of Bhim Koregan celebrations violence, where it actually happened. And that's why on that case, he has been arrested. I hope now you guys understand that who he stands for me and why he was been arrested, on what basis. Now let's talk about our, you know, the highlight of our video today, which is UAPA. So, On 17th June, where 1996, due to, you know, the Naxalbari present uprising, which was actually happens at that time, where so many movements has been happening. So that's why on that note, where this unlawful activities prevention ordinance was actually, you know, promulgated, and then it was finally came into the existence. Okay. So if you talk about the timeline, and then since then, you know, even though enactment, there has been associations being declared, you know, unlawful under the Criminal Law Act 1952 as well. But UAPA has been amended twice, okay, in 2004 and 2013 to expand its scope. Right. So we keep on amend according to the, you know, situations and for the time being. Right. So, yes, there has been two times it has been amended, like the punishment for terror activities and acts and all, and acts threatening the country's security, okay, like economic security as well. And not only that, provisions to prevent the use of funds for terrorist purposes, including money and all. So these were all the extra amendments which was actually taken up while the two amendments has been taken. And not only that, the ban on organizations, where initially it was 2 years, okay, under this, it was 2 years, and later on it has been extended for 5 years. Okay, from 2 years it was extended to 5 years. This was it. And the further amendments give, you know, various anti-terrorism resolutions, so which comes under United Nations Security Council and FATF, which is Financial Action Task Force. And not only that, even in 2019 recently it was amended, where the government to designate individuals as terrorists. So here the government itself got the major power, which they actually, you know, designate any kind of an individual as terrorist. So this is what actually happened in Stan Swamy's case. Okay, so not only this, is just like another special laws dealing with narcotic drugs or defunct laws on terrorism and all, this also modifies the code of criminal procedure. Okay, so where this actually gave more power for this, UAPA, like a remand order, where it used to be 30 days instead of usual 15 days. Okay, so where it got 30 more days, like 15 days extra. And maximum period of judicial custody before, you know, filing the charge sheet is actually extendable, like to 180 days. Like usually it was 90 days. Okay, so from 90 days, it got to 180 days. And not only that, the remand, earlier it used to be 15 days, now it got 30 days. So this extension, like this extra power given for that. So if you talk about why there has been the controversies and all, now let's talk about what were the, you know, issues which were actually raised on this UAPA. First itself, the definition of this terrorist act. So what exactly the terrorism or the terrorist act given under this UAPA, which was definitely not the one which was, referred or verified by United Nations. Okay, and the protection of human rights and fundamental freedoms. So what exactly of this UAPA's Terrorism Act actually makes up, like which includes death or injuries or to any person, damage or to any property, etc. And not only that, like see, where it actually gives a major thing. And the major, major problem under this UAPA is that difficult to obtain bail. So this is the major problem which was actually happens in the Stan Swamy's case, where he was denied multiple times the bail. Okay, even on the, you know, purpose of health conditions also, he's been denied. So that what it leads to major focus on to repeal or, you know, to remodify this UAPA rules and regulations and all. So yes, under Section 43D5, where it is difficult for any accused person to obtain bail where it can be rejected multiple times and all. So yes, because of that, if it keep on rejects, so it doesn't give, you know, the guarantee of constitutional right to liberty. So where the liberty and the person's basic right will be denied. Okay, so that is also came into the existence. Okay, and not only that, pendency of trials, and not over that, the state overreach, like it kind of gives a threaten for the people or strike terror in the people. Right, and not only that, the state authority vague powers to detain and arrest individual whoever it believes that they might have indulged in the terrorist activities, you know, unless going for a proper investigation, they could straight away, you know, it might affect, you know, or it might make the state government to, you know, doubt a person. And if they doubt and they just simply indulge that he has been arrested under UAPA, so it will also make, you know, has a probability of, you know, misusing of this UAPA Act, right? And yes, that is why this, the major obtaining bill was the major difficulty, which was, and the principal reasons for, you know, for Father Swami's death, because he was actually a prisoner and then he was moved to hospital because of his unhealth and all. So, which actually compromises his constitutional liberties and all, right? So, yes, this is about I wanted to discuss. And as you could see that there has been active UAPA cases on the rise, where from, you know, since this act got its amendments, like from 2014 to 19, as you could see, so where the cases pending and cases bought again, the years where, as you could see, there have been keep on increase in the graph till 2019, like in and around 5,134 cases has been registered. So if the case has been kept on pending, so the person who has been accused as a terrorist, it might take a longer time for them to, you know, to get out of that. And even if it was proved innocent, he was not terrorist, so again, as we could see, it won't go out of the public records because he will be treated as a terrorist, where of course he has been accused in the very first place. So there are so many things where it actually, you know, kind of make a classical dilemma, right? So it actually draws a line between, you know, the individual freedom and, you know, the state obligation to provide security, where, you know, there has been a mismatch and kind of creates a dilemma for the people and, you know, for the judiciary as well. But, you know, it is up to the state and judiciary or the civil society where they need to strike the balance between the constitutional freedom and the imperative of anti-terror activities. So, you know, making a proper investigation and, you know, looking up for major, you know, changes where it doesn't affect in a major, you know, anti-proposition ways. So that's why there has been, you know, this article or this act was came into the news and came into the focus. So I hope you all understand what is UAPA and why this was in news. So UAPA, what it is and why it was in news, because Stan Swamy, he was an activist. So tribal activist, where he has been arrested under UAPA because of 2018, where it is 200th anniversary of Bhim Koregan battle celebrations, which was actually happens in Pune. So yes, under this violence where it was broke on that day. So on that violence case, he has been arrested under he has been arrested and then UAPA Act has been implemented in his, you know, case. So why this major situation was actually happens because of this celebrations which were actually happened. So what celebrations? You know, Bhim Koregan celebrations. So why those celebrations happens, I've explained in the very first thing. So yes, this is the link of everything about this article. I hope you understand and we'll get back to you soon with another video. Thank you, and please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and click the bell icon for notifications, and do check out our website in the description box below. Thank you.